Thank you so much for the warm welcome. I appreciate you for being here. Hi, guys. Hi, Ding Paul. Good to see you all. What a beautiful room of people here. Again, could you give a round of applause for Brian? I think he did great, by the way. So, welcome, welcome, welcome. How are you guys doing today? All good? Like Brian was saying, English is not my first language, so if you forgive me, my accent, this is real, by the way, I'm not faking it. I really have this accent. So first of all, thanks very much for being here. We are the crazy ones, right? And I feel great for being here, because you are the people that I want to be surrounded by. And I love you guys, and thank you so much for attending this this great event. I appreciate you. An applause for you guys. So what I want to do here today, I want to tell you my story. How many of you know my story? Because I don't want to bore you too much if the whole room knows my story. So I'm going to keep it compressed. But I think it's important to let you know where I come from, so you guys know that I'm just a normal guy. I'm no someone special with special skills or anything like that. I'm just a normal guy that obviously took some, you know, actions to change my life. So I just want to go from the beginning, tell you a little bit about myself, how I did it, and then obviously teach you as well, because I want to leave you and not just pump you up, give you motivation and leave you with nothing. So I'm going to teach you obviously what worked for me in Empower Network. So if I could just have my slides on the screen, please. So here we go. Mindset and traffic mastery is what I want to talk to you guys about. And how, thank you. And how I went from zero in Empower Network 14 months ago when I started to $419,985 in 12 months. Thank you. Income disclaimer, here we go. Just an outline, I want to just go through a few pointers. All, you know, what am I talking about to you guys tonight? See, who am I and why should you listen to me? How did I start online? Why I chose internet marketing as a vehicle for my freedom? I want to talk to you about the biggest secret you got to learn here today. You guys want to know what it is? Believe you me, it's not the traffic. I know you all here for the traffic and you want to know the secrets. Yeah, traffic is important, absolutely important, but the biggest secret you got to find out here today, and I promise you this is 100% true, and I'll prove to you, it's mindset. Do you guys understand what I'm talking about, mindset? Yeah? And I'll go through a few things with you. So the biggest secret I found, really, I call it the Aladdin's lamp. And why I call it Aladdin's lamp is because he has allowed me to have anything I want. And it doesn't have to be always about financial and about money, but it really allowed me to have everything I want in life. And I'll go through the steps on how you two can achieve that. Does that make sense? Yeah? I'm going to talk also about the world within and the world without. And I'll explain to you guys in a minute what I mean by that. And why success online really, really is 80% mindset and only 20% mechanics. So a lot of people think it's just traffic, 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 and really isn't. 80% is mindset, guys. So ever think about that, because that will really change your business. If you apply that metric of 80% mindset, 20% mechanics, you will really get it. I promise you, because I've done that and it worked wonders for my business. And then finally, I will speak to you about traffic and tracking, which is the mechanics really, the 20%. I'm going to teach you how I built my Empower Network business through solo ads, because you need to build your list, by the way. You should be collecting emails like what Michelangelo teaches. Collect emails every day, and it really works. It works for my business. I do that every single day. All I do, really, lately, I just collect emails, and then I create a relationship with my list, and then I introduce them to, obviously, to Empower Network. I'm going to talk also about reciprocal list swaps, which is a way of how I generate leads. That's all I do, by the way. Every day is I get leads, I get emails, I collect emails. And then I will talk to you about one of my favorite forms of advertising, which is banner advertising, but the way I do it. So just to give you a bit of a story so you guys know where I'm coming from and all that, I'm Portuguese, by the way. I've immigrated to England when I was 18 years old. And I just wanted a different lifestyle. I wanted to have a better life. I wanted to travel the world and just meet new people. And the problem was, when I arrived in England, I spoke no English whatsoever. My English was non-existent. And I didn't have a college degree. So, and I didn't have a lot of money. So I had to get into various laborious jobs like bar work, McDonald's, etc. Until really I fell into a profession of printing. So I got into printing, I started working there, and I started learning in English. And the reason why I want to share this experience with you when I became a printer was that really was a turning point in my life when I was printing. I remember going to my manager then, and this was a turning point. This is why I need to share this with you. And I went to him, my English was better, and I wanted to, you know, to grow within the company. And I remember asking him for a pay rise in a different position. And the turning point was when he told me that he wouldn't give me that position. He actually said something that actually floored me, which was, Paulo, you're not ready for this pay rise, you're not ready for this new position. And by the way, you will never amount to anything anyway. And what I did very cleverly, you know, I could have accepted. And what I did very cleverly is I could have accepted his opinion of me, and I would just say, hey, he's an older gentleman. I was a kid, I was 18 years old, by the way. So I could have just said, you know, he's right, and I could have just, you know, do nothing with that and just be a nobody. But what I did, I actually got I got really angry with him, and I said to myself, I'm going to prove to this guy that actually I can do something with my life. And actually I did, because within 6 months of just working hard and working really towards what I was trying to achieve, which was a pay rise and having a higher position, I actually took the position of manager from that very same office where he was working, and he actually left. So that's just to prove to you that when you guys have... Thank you. That's just to prove, you know, when you put something in your mind, it all starts in the mind, you know? I didn't let that guy's opinion of me become my reality. So what I did was, I'm going to change this. And I asked, how? How can I change this? And I just worked towards it. And then I've achieved, obviously, the position of manager just by working hard, really, and working on my vision and working with, you know, at the end results. So what happened was, you know, I was there. I worked for that company for like 17 years, by the way. I was there for a long, long time. And the money was okay, but I'll tell you what happened was I've got two kids, by the way, and when they were born, I had no time. I was a part-time dad. I was working for this company for like 10, 12-hour shifts, and I never used to see them. And that, as a dad, pained me, that I couldn't see my kids due to a lot of bad investments that I've done. I was actually broke, and I tell you the truth, I used to get paid on the first of every single month, and by the 15th, I was absolutely broke. I had no money left. And that, as a family guy, you know, it pained me that I couldn't provide for my family. It pained me the fact that I couldn't take my kids to like Disney World and buy them gifts and, you know, and go out and have dinner with them and, you know, and just support my family. So I start thinking, you know, I have been successful in this business. I've made it in the corporate world, but I want more. I want freedom. I want time and freedom, really. I wanted the money, but to create time and freedom. So I started researching on the internet, and I came across internet marketing, which is the vehicle, by the way, that I chose to have my freedom. And I remember for the longest time ever, we're talking about 7-8 long years, I tried everything under this earth. Any deals, any programs, MLMs, pyramid schemes even, I joined them all. And I failed miserably at everything that I touched, you know, and I don't know why I failed, and I'm going to tell you in a second why. But everything I touched, I was a crab magnet, that's what I call it, you know. I was an absolute crab magnet. Everything I touched, I would just fail. And I could never understand why, because I knew, you know, there was people making money. There was people making money in Amway, there was people making money in Avon, there was people making money in whatever the companies that maybe I shouldn't be mentioning on stage. But the reason, and I fell, and then I start, you know, very cleverly, very cleverly, I started to ask myself, hold on a second, there are people making money in those companies, yet I'm not making any money. Because I was a crap magnet, I kept blaming everyone else for me not being successful. And I kept saying, oh, I'm not successful because of my sponsor. That's my sponsor's fault. It's not mine. It's my sponsor's fault. I'm not successful because my parents never gave me an education. I'm not successful for fill in the blank. Until I start realizing, hold on a minute, hold on a second, there's people making money in all these companies, yet I am not making any money. So what did I do? Obviously, I start thinking, it's within me. I need to change myself. Do you guys get that? Am I making any sense here? So I start realizing, really, the problem weren't with the companies, the problem were with the systems. The systems weren't broken. I think it was me. So I start asking the question, how can I make myself work? And instead of getting the problem out of myself. Have you guys ever noticed something? Every time you have a problem, yeah, with anything, with anybody, have you noticed something? You are always there. It's crazy, yeah? Ever think? It took me a while. I had to think that. I had to go to the dictionary and translate it into my language. What does that mean? It really is. It really is within you. You are the biggest obstacle or enemy. It's you. And it's not your sponsor. Does that make sense, guys? Okay. So what I did, I started looking for a mentor, really, to teach me. Because every time I would buy a course or try to something online, it never worked. So I started looking, okay, let me get someone who's got a proven path that can teach me, you know, how to do this online thing. Because I was fed up of failing. I really was. You know, I never shared this on stage, but I used to go to bed some nights with tears, just crying my eyes out. Because I couldn't provide for my family, and I felt like a failure. And, you know, and I never shared this with anybody, but it's the absolute truth, you know. I really reached rock bottom, you know. And from that, you know, I never give up, because I had a strong why, you know, and my why, obviously, was to change my life. So with that said, I went online and found a guy who had a proven path. He done very well online. I've contacted him. I traced him online, and I found his number, and I called him, and I was in a desperate place, and I asked him for help, you know. And luckily he did, you know, he said, yeah, I'm gonna mentor you, but you've got to change your mindset. And he started going on about mindset, and I've never heard any so-called guru online tell me about mindset. Everything is about, yeah, buy my course, do this, and you got to make money. But this guy was different. So he put me on a 30-day program about changing my mindset. And I'm going to be honest with you, I was a bit taken back by that. And Holly said, you need to follow this for 30 days and you don't ask any questions. So with that said, I'd like just to show you my next slide. Are you guys ready to learn something that can change your lives here today? You are, eh? Pay close attention. Look, it's not the traffic secret that's going to change your life. And it's not that either. Let me go back, sorry. Right, this is the secret. This is the secret that mentor that I just told you about told me to do for 30 days, and that would change my life. In the beginning, I didn't quite understand, you know, what is this going to do for me? But you know, guys, I can't stress this enough. The ones of you that got to pay attention to this and do it, and I've got proof that this works. I've got proof in my life, and some of my friends, my closest friends, they've done this. And it really, really works. So we call it the 30-30 rule. And basically, it's really basic, guys. It's not science or, I mean, it's not brain surgery or something difficult like that. Rocket science, that's the word. You read for 30 days. And I'm going to tell you which books to read, by the way. I was never a reader. You know, I never used to read books. And the cliche when people say that leaders are readers, it's really true, and it really, really works, trust me. So you read for 30 minutes a day, you listen to a positive audio for 30 minutes every single day, 7 days a week, by the way. And if you want to know what audios I listen to, Inner Circle. How many guys here have an Inner Circle? Yeah, good stuff, good. Hand of applause for you guys, I applaud you. Everyone in this room should get the Inner Circle, because those are the audios that I listen to every single day, you know. And you gotta do it for 30 days. And I tell you what, I've done this for 30 days. And do you remember when I said I was a crap magnet? It changed me. I'm not gonna say here that after 30 days I was like, you know, a completely changed person and money started pouring in and all that. That's not what happened. But after 30 days, you know, something happened, something switched within me. And I really start seeing light at the end of the tunnel. I don't know how to explain this to you in words, really. but my whole paradigm, it was like a paradigm shift. And I start, you know, attracting people into my life, you know, and making the right business decisions and all that. And to tell you the truth, I became fearless. You know, I wasn't afraid anymore to invest in the business, you know. And what I did after I done the... Oh, by the way, let me just go and tell you what books I'm reading. This is some of the books that you guys should make a note of, by the way. All these books here, I've read them and they've changed my life. But I would recommend especially three books that I urge you to go out. When you live here, go on Amazon.com or whatever company you want to go to and just buy them. You know, they're not even expensive. And the names of these books are Secrets of the Millionaire Mind by T. Harv Eker, Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill, Start with the Why by Simon Sinek. Those three books here have changed my life. And I'm not just saying it to look good. I actually read those books. They absolutely changed my life. You know, the message there, you've got to read them and really implement them in your life. And if you guys do that, one thing I can promise you, it will change you. It will change your lives. That I can promise you. And I'm sorry to go on for so long about mindset, but this stuff just works. And to prove to you, I spoke, I think this was back in Denver, about mindset. And I met a couple, I believe in Denver, I could be wrong here because I've been to so many events, that they really took on board what I was saying about mindset. And I want you guys to listen from the horse's mouth, really, what changed to them. And it's the power couple are here today. Paulo, would you mind, can I just have a mic here, just for Paulo, just to quickly just have a few words on how mindset has changed his business?
It's made all the difference. And it was actually Washington, D.C., and we were upstairs. I think it was like a party going on. And, you know, me and my wife were about to go to bed. And honestly, I wasn't really feeling too good. I was kind of feeling defeated. And I came, you know, she's like, hey, Paulo's over there. You want to talk to him? I was like, yeah, I mean, he has the same name as you. And I was like, all right, whatever. So I went over there, and, you know, that's where I really met you. And, you know, you just kind of looked at me. You know, you placed your hand on my shoulder. And you say you believe in me.
A round of applause, right? For Paulo.
You believed in me. And then that really did a lot. You know, and then my wife too. You know, I got to give her credit. She's always believed in me from the beginning.
Well done, man.
And I love her, man. I love her. And then in March 2014, which was not too long ago, I was tired. And I looked at myself in the mirror. Well, it was kind of like a reflection, and I said, man, I'm going to get 2 signups today from my wife, because I felt you, you know. I wanted to provide for my wife. And literally, when I said to myself, I'm going to get 2 signups today, I went back out, and in an hour, I got a signup. In an hour, I got a signup, and that's when the belief started hitting. And then all of a sudden, we went from getting 2 signups in a week to, and it started coming in maybe 4 signups, and then all of a sudden that belief just started adding another belief and another belief and another belief and another belief, to the point where every day we wake up, we just know we're going to get signups, we just know we're going to get leads. But I just want to say that I really appreciate you, man.
Oh, you're welcome, man. I just wanted to share. It's not about me. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks for sharing. Did you guys hear him say anything about traffic? Ever think about that? It's all about belief. And for you guys to be here attending the events, you know what this got to do for you? It's got to lift you up. It's got to lift up your belief. Remember that word, belief. It's all about belief. The reason why the leaders here, they do so well and they speak with so much passion, it's because they believe. I didn't have that belief when I first joined. I didn't know Empower Network. I was sitting back there watching the likes of Tony Rush and David Wood and Sharp and all these leaders speaking. I was getting inspired, but I was thinking, can I do this? You know, it's just little me, you know, I'm just a nobody. You know, they're up there, you know, they're big guys, you know. All these guys, mindset, belief. I don't even speak English properly, for crying out loud. You know, it's down to you really to make it happen, to believe that this can be the business. This could be your last rodeo. Like, you know, it really can. It's down to belief. So just raise your belief system. Believe that you can do it. And guess what? Like Paulo just said, you know, having all these synapses every single day, you can do it also. You really can. It's really down to you. Let me just go back to my slides because I want to train you as well. I'm going to give you some training. But that really was my talk about mindset. What's your name and where are you from, sir?
I'm Nicholas Steele from England via Spain. We flew in from Spain. But I just want to share with everyone the power of the mind, how powerful it is. And when you have a dream, you can achieve anything. 7 years ago, after a freak accident, I was left paralyzed from the neck down. And I was told that I'd never move again. I was a complete quadriplegic. My wife left me, took my son with her and said I'd never see him again, that I could never be a real man again. But it took me 4 years. And the dream I had was to recover, to walk again and get my son back into my life. And I achieved it. And I use the power of the mind. So for anyone here, if you really use mindset and change your mindset and believe that anything is possible,
it works.
You can achieve absolutely anything. I'm living proof.
Thank you so much for sharing that. Thank you. Come on. Well done. Thank you. The power of the mind. Did you guys like the video as well? Yeah, good stuff, good stuff. Yeah, well, that's what I do, and I get motivated from that. That's a big message there, that you should just listen over and over and over again. And I wish I could just drill this message into your heads, really, you know? Anyway, back to training now. Who wants to know about traffic? Hey, sorry, Tanya, how are you? Could I have a round of applause for Tanya, please? Thank you. There should be someone coming. One sec. There you go.
I just got back with wife. Yeah. Okay, so I just have a very short question. That video you showed was so motivating that I was almost in tears, but I just want to know, did you find that on YouTube? Do you have the link URL or something we can look up?
I have, it's
up
on
to
YouTube. If you just type in Les Brown Dream, it will come up on YouTube.
Les Brown Dream, okay, Dream, cool, because yeah. I'm like, I want to watch that every day.
Cool.
That is very motivating.
Thank you.
Thanks
for the feedback.
Yeah.
Guys, any more questions? Because I think my time is up. Are we good? Cool. Thank you very much for being here. I appreciate you. I hope I didn't bore you too much. And the next person I would like to introduce is Justin de Varenge. He doesn't need any introductions anyway, but he's the next speaker. So thanks very much for being here. I appreciate you and I love you.